And match 8 is our game of the day from the Reebok. It's Bolton Wanderers against Manchester United. I'll remind you how to access those games when the match choice segment of the programme starts at 10:15. And after you've watched the one for you, Nigel Winterburn will be here to analyse the key moments from all today's games. But first to our game of the day. Both Bolton and Manchester United had made best ever Premiership starts this season. Bolton started the day in third. Manchester United had been top. Today they met at the Reebok. Just one change for Sam Allardyce after victory over Blackburn last Sunday, and that was enforced by the suspension of Kevin Nolan for his sending off in that game. Stelios, the man to replace him. And one change for United as well. Cristiano Ronaldo had recovered from illness to take his place in the starting 11. Fletcher dropped to the bench. Wayne Rooney was looking for his first goal since the opening weekend of the season. Commentary at the Reebok from Trevor Francis and Rob Palmer.
Well, before the game, Sam Allardyce told his players to go out there without fear. If they can do that, and if they can beat Manchester United, Bolton would overtake them in the Premier League. And I think the scene has been set with a raw challenge in the opening seconds of the game.
Yes, just on the back of Cristiano Ronaldo's calf muscle from Ben Ahim, just letting him know that he's about. I mentioned the fact that Manchester United need to win. They would, of course, have heard the Chelsea result prior to kickoff, so that makes it even more important that they come here this afternoon looking for 3 points.
Chelsea back at the top of the Premier League. It's all very tight this season, and Sir Alex will show opponents no mercy. He'll go for goals. Of course, that's the reason they were top at the start of the day. They're ahead of Chelsea on goals difference. Paul Scholes revitalised. What a great comeback it's been for Scholes. Ferdinand to Ryan Giggs, the old guard combining. Zaha. Ivan Kappa can't get the tackle in. Scholes. Gary Neville on the blind side. Fires one in, and good handling by Jaskalainen.
Well, there's another late challenge that comes in. As Zaha drops the ball off, Campbell catches him very late. Rob Stiles allows play to continue. Gary Neville on the overlap puts a ball in hard and low, but good handling by Jaskalainen.
Bissar with a good early kick. I don't think Wayne Rooney was listening to the manager's instructions before the game, because he wasn't prepared to chase that. Jaskalainen, the hero last week with two penalty saves against Blackburn Rovers. Davis. There's Diouf. Elka chasing the ball. Diouf is here on the right-hand side. Evra doing the splits.
It was noticeable, Rob, that when Jaskalainen kicked the ball downfield, he concentrated on trying to put it onto the head of Kevin Davis. I think we'll see plenty of that, because up against Kevin Davis is Evra, who is probably the smallest player in the Manchester United team. And that's where I think that Bolton may look to try and get a bit of success. Kevin Davis getting them little flick-ons into the feet of either Anelka or Elhadj Diouf.
Anelka, of course, hasn't scored in the Premier League since signing for Bolton Wanderers. What better time than today? Zaha. Campo with a dangerous header. Nita gave it away very cheaply. The referee acknowledging there may have been a consideration for a free kick, but gives United the advantage, which is taken. Giggs tries to get it onto his left foot. He does so. It's a magic wand of a left foot for Giggs. And it trickled just wide.
Well, only Ryan Giggs would know whether this was a cross or a shot. But it was clever footwork from Ryan Giggs. He was closed down by two players and pushed the ball through one of the Bolton players' legs. Typical Ryan Giggs cleverness around the edge of the box.
Free header for Ferdinand. So I'm not backing into Mita. This is Scholes. Zaha. Great cross in there, and Giggs was just shoe size away from scoring.
Well, all the early Manchester United attacks are coming down this right-hand side. Gary Neville's put one or two balls in. On this occasion, Ronaldo, it's a delightful ball into that area, which is always a problem between defenders and goalkeeper. Two red shirts going in on it, but neither could make any contact.
It's Rooney to Zaha. It's great verve and a great heartbeat to this game already. A classic Saturday afternoon tie, 3 o'clock kickoff between two local sides, with top and second place at stake in the Premiership. Desart, there's Hunt, Scholes, now Ferdinand, Ronaldo to Ferdinand. Great movement off the ball by Manchester United. Zaha, Carrick, Rooney, Giggs with space, great ball, and Evra, tidy save. It was a full-back's finish, wasn't it?
Magnificent football from Manchester United. Jaskalainen, he came, he hesitated, held his position, and then he brought off a wonderful save to deny Evra. But it was a sweeping move from Manchester United. Plenty of one-touch football. They've started this game very confidently.
Booze for Ronaldo. He expects that. Scholes, defence buddy ball, and Neville's there. The unfortunate thing for Manchester United in the opening minutes of this game, they've had two chances, but it's fallen to the feet of the fullbacks. Big save from Jaskalainen.
Great ball from Rooney. Giggs, first time in from into Evra. There, Jaskalainen, he comes, he hesitates, but he stands big and makes the save from Evra.
Evra still hasn't scored for United. It's Fang. Rooney picks his pocket, claims he was brought down, had a moan at the referee, turned round, and now he's got to control himself and remember those anger management classes that he had. It was 50-50, and there was a bit of a tangle. Your expert view, Trevor?
Well, obviously, Wayne Rooney thought that he was being pulled back by Faye.
Oh, Giggs goes through the defender. Giggs right across. Oh, and there was nobody there to apply the gloss touch.
Well, how many times in the opening few minutes have Manchester United got in behind the fullbacks? This time, the combination, Evra to Giggs, through the legs of Hunt, plays the ball across the face of the goal, and yet again there's nobody there to get that all-important touch.
Rip-roaring start without a goal. Manchester United full on. Scholes leading the charge. Now Carrick. Bolton have a player down. Will Campo put it out of play to allow treatment? No, they continue. There's Anelka. Well, he's lonesome at the moment, so he'll just have to wait for some support in this cavalry charge. Diouf. Here's Cristiano Ronaldo to Zaha. Rooney had gone just a fraction too early.
Nothing wrong with the pass from Zaha. Bolton held a good line, a high line. Wayne Rooney just went slightly early.
Davis, the obvious target for Jaskalainen. Backs into Ferdinand. Campo beaten by Ronaldo. Hunt. Stelios is a rather theatrical attempt to win a free kick. Rooney, oh, what a great pass. Zaha right across the defender. It took two to stop him, and Zaha doesn't quite make it. Bolton still haven't escaped. It's Ronaldo. They're knocking at the door, but they can't blow it down at the moment. Carrick. Giggs, lovely touch. Anywhere will do for Stelios. Bolton struggling at the moment to get out of their own half. Evra. Zaha. Ronaldo. And Faye looks a little dizzy and he's happy just to take a bit of a breather here. Then he's going to have to pump it towards the halfway line.
Well, it was Faye who came to Bolton's rescue. He had the presence of mind to go back onto the goal line to deny Zaha what would have been a delightful chip.
Carrick. Well, Faye has lost it. And Rooney's there. And Rooney scores! The fast is over. Hasn't scored since the opening day of the season. But that was a present for the man who turned 21 this week.
Well, Michael Carrick plays a hopeful ball in behind the Bolton back four. Rooney in between Hunt and Faye. Faye misjudges the bounce, but Rooney's onto it like a flash, composes himself, shows great technique, hits it with his left foot, gets right over the ball and drills it past Jaskalainen with his left foot. It's only what Manchester United deserved. The opening 10 minutes, they've been quite outstanding.
Rich. Giggs. It has been an exceptional start from Sir Alex Ferguson's side.
Really, Bolton have had no answer to the attacking play of Manchester United. They've been so positive from the very first minute. They've come out of the blocks, taken the game to Bolton. They've had many, many opportunities, but this was the opening goal, and it was a great effort from Wayne Rooney. He's fully deserved that because he's been the one that's been the biggest threat in the opening few minutes.
The first goal that Bolton Wanderers have conceded at home this season.
And only the fifth goal they've conceded this season, I believe.
It is today. It's the best attacking team against the best defensive team in the Premier League. And it's Manchester United who are living up to their billing so far. Sir Alex has to be absolutely delighted with the start from his players. Campo. Putting it long for Anelka. Vidic intercepts. Scholes. Goals to Carrick. All nice one-touch, two-touch stuff from the men from Manchester. Hunt. There's Davis. Miscued. Scorer Rooney cushions the ball. Carrick. Giggs. Evra. Two central defenders looking very uncomfortable and the ball is given away cheaply again to Ronaldo. Oh, Jaskalainen spilled it! He gets there at the second attempt.
Well, if Ryan Giggs had been a little bit more alert, he probably could have got onto that spilled attempt by Jaskalainen. Initially, Jaskalainen's kick was a poor one. Ronaldo gathers it, composed himself, hits him with his left foot.
Well, he's recovered from a bout of flu, Cristiano Ronaldo. Manchester United are in fine health.
I'm just looking at Sammy Lee coming to the side of the touchline there, just trying to get the players just to settle down, just to relax. It's been a whirlwind start. I think it's really shaken Bolton at the speed that Manchester United have attacked them at.
So now nice sitting on the back row of the coach's area. As his spotters all wired up. Be pretty much a hotline at the moment amongst the Bolton coaching staff. How do they turn it around? He's picked an offensive lineup. El Hadji Diouf. Easy catch for Van der Sar, breaking his boredom.
Because of the fact that Nolan's not playing, I mentioned that Stelios is in the midfield. He's playing directly against Paul Scholes. Mosteles is noted for his attacking play. This afternoon he's going to have to be a little bit more defensive. It's a big ask, because he does like to get forward. It's not a natural game for Stelios, but he's got a job to do for the team.
The Bolton have been in great form and beaten in six games. They've won the last four in the Premier League. This is a true test today against the champions elect. Scholes to Neville. Saha. Cristiano Ronaldo to Giggs. Again, they give the ball back to Jaskalainen, and it's almost as if he's got the wrong boots on today. Do you see Jaskalainen?
Another feature of Manchester United's play, Rob, is the fact that, if we just see this foul by Stelios climbing all over Rooney, it's how advanced Gary Neville has been in the first few minutes. What's happening is Ronaldo is coming in very narrow into a central position, and it's allowing Gary Neville to push forward into a very advanced position down that right-hand side. As we see now,
point,
it's a
Ruben
two-on-one
Tremont
situation here.
Here's Neville, leads the charge. Rooney! He's on fire! He's kept a clear head in the week of his birthday. He's scored two goals in the opening 16 minutes.
Well, it's a fantastic finish from Wayne Rooney, but you can't give him that kind of room. Bolton are very slow to close him down. I think Stelios is the culprit. As the ball is played, Rooney takes possession. Stelios comes across. Comes off Ben Ahim. Rooney takes possession. He should have been closed much, much quicker, but he picks his spot and he actually passes it with his right foot inside of Jaskalainen's left-hand post. Lovely finish yet again from Wayne Rooney.
Perfection from the England striker. Bolton nil, Wayne Rooney 2 with 16 and a bit minutes gone. Bolton need a quick response. It's a landslide at the moment. Campo's long throw bounces dangerously in the penalty area. Ferdinand keeps a cool head. Ronaldo to Neville. Saha. Stelios. And Van der Sar comes a long way. That's a great take by the Dutch international.
Absolutely vital when you play against Bolton. You've got a keeper who's prepared to come off his line just to take the pressure off the back four. That's what Van der Sar did then. Bolton are so dangerous aerially.
Ronaldo. Campo only part halts him. Carrick. Rooney. Scholes. Ronaldo. Bolton are chasing shadows cast by Manchester United at the moment. Carrick. Poor pass. Hit away by Ben Haim. Now a rare counter-attack led by Nicola Anelka. Davis is to his right. Oh, dear me. A complete and utter miskick.
Well, we saw something similar, didn't we, over in Croatia on a divot. Certainly affected Paul Robinson, cost him England's second goal on that occasion there. Anelka took an air shot, so embarrassing for a player, but it was down to a divot that would come loose on the field. I think Anelka chose the wrong option anyway, because Elad Diouf had made the extra man to his right and really should have picked him out.
But it has been a tremendous tempo for Manchester United. Gary Neville to Scholes. Sir Alex, of course, had the luxury of dipping into the gold reserves that they have at Old Trafford these days and flooding a lot of the fringe players against Crewe. They did it the hard way in the League Cup in midweek, and Sir Alex wasn't particularly happy with the enthusiasm of some of the players. But the break that the first team have had has paid off. have been fit and fresh, taking the chances today, unlike Bolton. Oh dear. Tottenham goalie will sympathise.
In all honesty, there's nothing you can do about that, Rob.
Well, he gets past the divots this time, but he gave it away to Ferdinand. Ronaldo.
Once again, the outlet is Gary Neville. Bolton have got to do something about that because Neville is getting far too much possession on that right-hand side.
Ben Haim. Never beats Davis in the air, but Campo picks up. Bolton really going to have to step up their game here. And Campo is going to be spoken to.
Well, Carrick was first to the ball, and Campo arrived with his foot high. It was a late challenge. Just a word of warning from Rob Stiles. There it is, with Campo leaves his foot in, lets Carrick know that he's about. I think next time, if there is a next time, he will certainly go into Rob Stiles' book.
Scots. Neville. Kicks at the moment over on the right wing. They keep interchanging here, and Cristiano Ronaldo.
Whilst you're on the subject of changes, Rob, at the moment it appears that Bolton have made a slight change. Campbell's now gone into the midfield on Carrick, and Speed appears to be the one who's playing the holding role in front of the back four. But of course that may change, but certainly what is very, very evident is that Stelios is the man who's going to try and get as tight as he can to Paul Scholes, which is not easy in the sort of form that Paul Scholes has been in this season.
There is Scholes to Giggs, who's come back to the left. Evra. Oh, he managed to get the cross in, and Jaskalainen just calms things. We talk about the mind games of Sir Alex after matches with his psychology, but today he's playing mind games during the course of the afternoon. Sam Allardyce makes a change, and then Sir Alex moves his players around again. It's like a very exciting game of footballing chess. Stelios may have been touched there. Ever couldn't quite believe it. It was, he says, it was just a touch, Rob Stone. Maybe didn't deserve the salver that Stelios did.
Well, Rob Stiles said it was just a little touch. I'm not sure it was even that. Stelios knew exactly what he was looking for, and he's got it. That's a free kick. I think it was very, very theatrical.
Well, Sammy Lee and Sam Allardyce are methodical in their preparation for set-piece situation. If Bolton are going to get back in the game, they may have to make the most of these odd opportunities. Stelios is making a real nuisance of himself in the wall there. Comes to Speed. Driven well, but without direction.
What Stelios was trying to do was prevent the charger, that being Paul Scholes, from getting to Gary Speed. He half does his job. Gary Speed gets the shot away, but can't quite direct it on target.
Speed, 37 years of age, his 494th Premier League game, more than any other player. Still going strong. Jaskalainen. Ronaldo. Drawn back by Diouf. Fay to meet up. Now Fay. Stelios. He's gone hunting for the ball. There's Anelka. Just too many to beat. Scholes buzzing. Got a good record against Bolton. He scored 7 goals against them in his career, including a bracer a couple of years ago. Campo to hurl the ball in. One little flick on, and Elka with a touch, and Gary Neville stays very resolute under some intense pressure from Davis.
Well, at the moment, the long throw from Campo appears to be Bolton's biggest threat. The initial header was flicked on and caused a little bit of panic in the Manchester United ranks.
Carrick to Evra. Hunt. It's all very hurried and panicky from Bolton Wanderers. Now Rooney, he's on the charge. He wants to make a sandwich out of the words of his critics in the last few weeks.
That was another great opportunity there as that ball was received by Wayne Rooney. He turned and he found himself 2-on-2. Ronaldo was the support player, but his control let him down at the vital moment.
Campo. Stelios is coming for Nolan today, but no way that he can do the role of Nolan. Distinctly different players. And Hatzdjouf. Sorry, this is Nicola Anelka throwing himself at Evra. Has had a very nervy start alongside Faye. Thrown together the Ivory Coast and Senegal internationals. Vidic. Scholes. Campo. Stelios pokes it to speed, which is asking a little bit too much. Cristiano Ronaldo, Rooney's in support. Gary Neville cantering down the right. Rooney spreads play to the left to Giggs. They're just overflowing with confidence.
Well, I suppose when you're 2-0 up after 20-odd minutes, it's worth a try. If the execution had been what he would have expected, I think we'd have been talking about the goal of the season.
Well, they're in the comfort zone at the moment, aren't they? They can try the party tricks.
It's a great crossfield ball from Wayne Rooney to pick out Ryan Giggs. Probably feels he should have taken it under control because he was one-on-one. He tried a speculative volley, which he didn't quite get right.
And de Sar, and there was a little bit of afters there. What happens to you if caught him going for the ball? I think there was any way there was ever going to beat the jolly green giant. Well, just caught him under the ribs. I don't think it was the worst challenge we're going to see on a goalkeeper this season. Maybe winded Van der Sar. Got away with the ticking off. Carrick. Ronaldo. Scholes. Zaha. Well, chanced his luck and he was very close.
I'm not sure if that even grazed the outside of the post. finds himself in a bit of space. Saha drives it. Well, it actually did. Jaskalainen's beaten. And this strikes the outside of the post.
I thought he may have taken a deflection off the defender as well, but a goal kick is given. Louis Saha, 6 goals, joint top scorer. Nobody's talking about Ruud van Nistelrooy leaving now, are they? Campo. Clattered by Saha, eager to get on with it. He's been well officiated by Rob Stiles. He's kept his cards dry so far with just under half an hour gone. Fussier referees may have shown a few flashes of yellow. Davis. Oh, he was crowded out by two or three defenders. Saha.
We just saw there, Rob, an absolutely towering header from Vidic. Really got up above everyone with a powerful header.
Almost putting the ball out of the ground, and that's no mean feat in this enclosed Reebok Stadium. Rooney. Scholes. Neville's touch to Ronaldo, a customary triple step over. Now Carrick, Saha, just too many to beat. He tries to go through them all, and Cristiano Ronaldo bringing a smile to the face of the Bolton supporters.
Well, it's all too easy, isn't it, for Manchester United? You just get that feeling that Bolton are afraid to get too close, or a little bit intimidated by this start from Manchester United. That was a real timid effort from Ivan Campo. Got to be a little bit more physical, I think, on Manchester United at the moment. They're doing more or less as they like, Manchester United.
Well, they're playing football with a smile on their faces. Fleet of foot Sir Alex's side. Speed. This is Mita. Given away again so cheaply. Ivan Campo. Hunt. Davis. Hunt. Rich. To Saha. Trying to do everything on his own. Well, he's managed to get a free kick out of Manchester United.
Good play from Anelka as Gary Neville dives in a little bit recklessly. Rob Stiles tried to play the advantage rule, but when Anelka lost possession, he quickly gave the free kick to Bolton.
Rob Stiles drawing the wrath of the home supporters by moving the ball about 2 feet then. Campo drives it into the far post, and that was a game, an excellent header from Vidic. He's having a very solid game.
Well, he's so important, isn't he, Vidic, on an afternoon like this. It sent Faye forward at the back post, but Vidic, once again, he was the man who won the aerial challenge.
Nicked in at the near post, kicks first there. Every man back for United. Rooney leads the escape committee. Malcolm bustles his way in. Ben Haim. It's about as close as Bolton have been in this game.
Well, it may have been close, but yet again, it doesn't test Van der Sar. And Elka does well, uses his strength against Gary Neville, holds the play up, waits for support, rows it into the path of Ben Haim, who controls the ball, then strikes it towards goal, but doesn't test Van der Sar.
Yeah. Manchester United started the day with a goals difference of +4. Chelsea won earlier by 2 goals, so a gap on the goals difference has been closed down. Sir Alex has an awful lot of admiration for Sam Allardyce. He'll want to go for the kill and he'll want to go for goals today. He'll want to repeat a 6-0 scoreline of 10 years ago. Giggs. And Jaskalainen has to play sweeper keeper. Hunt. Duff. Draws Vinic. No way round the mountainous Manchester United central defender. Back to his sharpest. Got a knee injury just before the World Cup, remember, and couldn't play for Serbia. Campo's throw. Then it was Vidic launching himself for the ball. Rooney may get the headlines, but he's had a tremendous performance, Vidic, alongside Ferdinand. Gary Neville. Cristiano Ronaldo. Scholes. Now Carrick. Players free all over the place. Bolton's marking is poor. This is Scholes. Ronaldo to Scholes, to Rooney, nobody touching him.
It's always a sign when confidence is up and you're playing well when you've got so many options. That's what Manchester United have got at the moment. Every time they receive possession, there's 2 or 3 options. Everhead, 1 or 2 options then, decided to go alone, overran the ball.
Diouf, interesting ball by Davis. Rescued by speed, now Campo. Nelka waits. Ben Haim goes to the left. Now cuts inside. Ben Haim goes toe to toe with Ferdinand. And Ferdinand was super cool.
Good play this from Nelka and Ben Haim. Not such good defending from Ronaldo. He was caught ball watching. Lost the run of Ben Haim. But fortunately, Rio Ferdinand, he did his defensive duties to deny Ben Haim.
Or speed try to play it to a friend rather than going for goal himself.
This is the first time Manchester United have been left wanting on a set piece. 2 players spear at the far post, it falls the speed. We had a free header and probably should have done better.
Speed's corner kick. Curled it right over the top of Van der Sar, lost his bearings. And Bolton get another corner in quick succession.
And once again, speed spare at the back post.
And he comes, oh! His call wasn't heard by Faye.
Well, there's no excuse for this from Manchester United. 30 seconds ago, they got done at the back post. Same 2 players, Faye and speed, both totally unmarked. Really, Faye should probably have heard the call from speed. He was better placed. But that's the real first opportunity that Bolton have had. In what has been a very one-sided first half.
First chink in the Manchester United armour. Vinic. Van der Sar. Step over, Hunt had to get there. Rooney was on the prowl again. Faye to Mita. Oh, there's no way out. They look completely lost when they're getting the ball at their feet, the Bolton back four.
I'm loath to criticise Bolton when they've conceded just 4 goals prior to this game and kept 6 clean sheets. But I have to say, the 2 centre-halves of Faye and Mita, they look as if they've never played together. They look so nervous at the back. And that edginess is really transmitting to the rest of the team.
It's about half a dozen throws they've had from this position. Campo's taken them all, and he hasn't managed to find a white shirt with many of them. Cristiano Ronaldo to Gary Neville. It's goals. Carrick. Order of the boot from Van der Sar. Ronaldo. Scholes alongside him. Neville. Ferdinand. Vidic. Carrick. Ferdinand. So, rare mistake from him. It was a hit and hope. Anelka was always getting underneath the ball and clutching at straws, really, with a shot like that.
Poor pass from Rio Ferdinand. Under no pressure, gives it to Anelka, who cleverly comes inside Scholes to make himself a couple of yards, hits it with his right foot. But once again, the shot doesn't test Van der Sar. But to be fair to Anelka, he's taken the fight to Manchester United in this first half. He's been the central striker, and he's been the one that really has taken it to Manchester United. But there haven't been too many opportunities for Bolton.
There's a chance for Rooney to get his hat-trick here. He takes his time. Well, now it's Sahar's opportunity. Bolton scramble it away. Manchester United straight back in their faces. Ball to Ryan Giggs! Big save, Jasker Leinen. Cristiano Ronaldo. Anywhere will do for Bolton at the moment. Great save.
Well, it wasn't with Ryan Giggs' favourite left foot, but he gets a great connection with his right foot. The ball deflected back into his path for Mita, and it produces a brilliant save from Jasker Leinen. Strikes it with his right foot, and a firm left-handed save from Jasker Leinen to deny Manchester United from going three up.
They chase the third before the break. They get the third, Bolton are out of its damage limitation. At 2-0, there's still a chance. Cristiano Ronaldo puts Ben Haim on the seat of his pants. Rooney. He needed to be on the end of his own cross, if you know what I mean.
Not the best of balls from Wayne Rooney. Giggs and Saha waiting for the ball into the near post area, but it was overhit from Wayne Rooney. He's allowed one mistake in this first half, isn't he?
Can't be critical of a man who scored two goals already. Line and hits it early. Food and drink for Rio Ferdinand. Is there a stray arm? The referee couldn't have been closer to say there's a bit of kidology in his view from Ronaldo. Davis heads it back in, but easy for Van der Sar to gather. Rooney, little tease up. And enough of a misdemeanour for the referee to give Manchester United the free kick. Yeah, there was a cracking of the shin guards. Carrick. Had Bolton thinking.
He's another one who's been excellent this afternoon. That Saha hasn't gotten the score sheet yet, but his movement is quite exceptional. Every time a Manchester United player has possession of the ball, he's always looking to find a different position. It must be a dream for any midfield player because of the fact that he's constantly looking to take up another position. And when he does get it, his control is so tight.
That's Diouf. Nelka supports him. Diouf thought he had the beating of Rio Ferdinand. I think that was overconfidence. Into the final 30 seconds of regulation time, the officials have decided there will be 1 minute added on. 30 seconds a goal then. Brahim leaves his left back position, which means Bolton are a man short at the moment. Gary Speed steps in. Neville fires it across. Anywhere will do for Faye. There's a cry there from Rooney, the referee, Rob Stiles, ignoring it.
Well, Rooney was right. He was manhandled to the floor there, Rooney, by Kevin Davis. 1 minute.
Davis hit the arm of Everett, and the referee's assistant gave that. Trevor, you've been in situations like this. You'd be preparing the half-time lecture in your head. What would you be saying if you were Sam Allardyce? How do you motivate these players?
Let's just have a look to see if they can get back in from this free kick, which shouldn't have been given because clearly that ball struck the chest of Edra. But it's a good opportunity for Bolton.
Overhit by Speed and just a touch from Van der Sar.
Well, the two previous free kicks, Manchester United's marking has been very poor. Faye and Speed have been totally unmarked at the back post. Let's see if it's any different this time.
Last chance of the first half. Davis gets there. Speed volleys his way in. Came off the back of Paul Scholes' shirt.
Well, yet again, nobody picks up Gary Speed. Over the years, he's been so dangerous in the air on set pieces. I can't believe that no one's been delegated to pick up Gary Speed.
Now well beyond the single minute that Rob Stiles headed on. Speed cuts it in, Campo gets a touch, and free kick is given. Now they can put the tee on in the changing rooms, I think. Half-time whistle goes. The locals are restless. The travelling Manchester United support absolutely delighted with their first half performance. It's been a team performance, but the star of the show, undoubtedly Wayne Rooney, in the week of his 21st birthday, scored after 10 minutes to make it 1-0 and 60 minutes later to give us a half-time scoreline at the Reebok of Bolton 0, Manchester United 2.
So Manchester United led by 2-0 at half-time at the Reebok. Both came from Wayne Rooney, his first goals in 8 matches in all competitions. And before we show you what happened in the second half, time for a quick reminder that all 8 Barclays Premiership games are available to you in Match Choice when we go interactive at 10:15. So Match 1 is Liverpool against Aston Villa. Everton went to the Emirates to play Arsenal in Match 2. Watford faced Tottenham in Match 3 at Vicarage Road. Match 4 sees Portsmouth's game against Reading. Match 5 is Wigan's trip to the Cottage to take on Fulham. The champions travel to Bramall Lane in Match 6, play Sheffield United. Newcastle played Charlton at St James's in Match 7. And Match 8 features extended highlights of our game of the day from the Reebok. And right now, let's get back to the second half action between Bolton and Manchester United in the company of Trevor Francis and Rob Palmer.
Whilst it's 2-0, Bolton still have a chance. And there's always going to be fight in the Sam Allardyce team. You get the impression that if Manchester United score a third, then Sam Allardyce has to go for damage limitation and they have to fear the 6-0 drubbing they got 10 years ago.
I'd imagine that during the half-time interval that Sam has stressed to the players that they've got to get a little bit closer to them. And when they do so, they've got to be a bit more physical, a bit more aggressive, because Manchester United have passed the ball too comfortably in this first half. Absolutely vital, the next goal. If Manchester United, as you said, were to get it, then the game is all over. If Bolton were to play for the first goal, that's what they've got to do. They've got to stick in the game, play for that first goal. They've always been a threat on set pieces. Once or twice, Gary Speed's been unmarked on corners. Campbell's long throw-in has always been a problem. And if they were to get that first goal, then it becomes a different game.
Speed who's had the better of the chances for Bolton. Now Cristiano Ronaldo, who's really not had a chance to break sweat, he's we were right on top of that, and he was taken out of it by Ben Haim.
Well, that was the most blatant obstruction I've seen for a long while. I can't believe Rob Stiles, who, by the way, has had a very good first half, didn't see that, because Ronaldo was going past Ben Haim. He positioned his body in front of him, blocked him off, and it's a clear free kick.
Ronaldo looked completely bemused by the ref's decision. There he is again. Neville to Scholes. Ferdinand, no need to take risks. It's back to Van der Sarne to keep his mind active. He's been a spectator for large lengths of this game. Evra to Giggs, to Rooney, to Ryan Giggs. Stopped by Ivan Campo, one of the few Bolton players who can say he's played close to his maximum today. Gritch.
I mentioned in the first half, Rob, that the two centre-halves of Bolton looked very, very edgy. It's interesting that Sam Allardyce has swapped them over in this second half. Mita is now playing on the right, and Faye is starting on the left-hand side.
Well, Campo is caught pretty nastily by Scholes. He offers an apology. Couldn't go in there with the intention of flattening the Spaniard. Trevor, you've pointed out the one weakness of United today has been occasionally at set pieces. They've allowed Gary Speed to get some freedom. It's over his head, and this time they do put up roadblocks.
It's not so much a weakness of Manchester United, it's a strength of Bolton. They do it week in, week out. They obviously work religiously on it on the training field. And they get a lot of success on a Saturday afternoon with it.
Speed with a javelin throw. And that's the first shot at goal. On target from Mita. He's got a long way back now because he had a sprint chase with Rooney. Davis. Stelios. Hunt. And that's Giff. Stelios has a look, hits it to the far post, and Van der Sar takes it well and sets United on the way through Gary Neville. Campo. It's been a bit breezier from the home side in the opening minutes of the second half. Anelka. Speed. Ben Haim. Speed using the height advantage of Davis. He turns Evra, puts in a fair cross, and Elka can't get there, and that was some acrobatic clearance from Vinic, and there's a handball on the edge of the area. Yes,
good spot, wasn't it, by the referee. This is a great ball in from Kevin Davis. But what a clearance this is from Vidic. I think Anelka was about to pounce and possibly would have scored, but it was a brilliant acrobatic clearance that from Vidic. But that was the threat that I talked about in the first half, that diagonal ball onto the head of Kevin Davis. He's so much taller than Evra.
And the signs are there could be a Bolton Wanderers revival. Hence the queue of potential free kick takers. A wall of five plus three others providing obstacles in the way for Anelka. Anelka goes for it. Oh, they're getting closer, inch by inch.
They may be getting closer, and it's a better start from Bolton in this second half, but they're not working the goalkeeper often enough. I think it's fair to say that the free kick there from Anelka, if it had been a couple of feet lower, then Van der Sar was across his goal and would have made the save.
Clumsy was the challenge of Faye. Ferdinand trots forward. Nine gigs to take. And Gary Neville. This looks rehearsed. Cristiano Ronaldo. That is rehearsed. He sure does that in his back garden when he gets home.
Well, they've decided not to put the ball into the box, but keep the ball, play it to feet. Much to the disappointment I had of Rio Ferdinand. He was signalling for the ball at the back post.
He's run a long way, hasn't he? Both thanked them for trying to play possession football. Davis. Meet up to the Askew line. A couple of big saves in the first half from the flying Finn. Referee didn't go with the call of the locals on the far side, who believed that Davis had been shoved in the back. As the star was explaining, he didn't see it, so he couldn't give it. Kicks. Evra. He did see that, and Davis is going to be in trouble. First caution of the afternoon is for Kevin Davis.
Absolutely none. And that was obviously painful for Evra.
Sir Alex down on the shop floor. There's his shop steward in Gary Neville. Sir Alex in the making. This is lieutenant on the pitch these days, the captain of the team. And it's not looking good for Evra at the moment. And the referee would like him to roll 4 or 5 yards to his left-hand side over the white line to receive the treatment. Or is it there and then?
Well, obviously, if he had to go off, it would be a big disappointment to the Frenchman, but in Gabriel Heinze, they've got the ideal replacement. Played during the week against Crewe, obviously back to full fitness and waited for his opportunity.
And there he is. Sir Alex is happy to have basically every position covered these days. John O'Shea has played at left back as well, but Heinze would be the natural replacement. Evra will not want to go off and give Heinze a look into the team, will he? Maybe some who tinker with a winning team, but generally not Sir Alex these days. He's found the formula, just the one change from last week. Ronaldo's fit to play, so he gets his place back in what Sir Alex considers to be his best 11, I'm sure. The form and fitness at the moment. Evra's back on. That's the cue for the booze.
Always amazes me, you know, when a player can get kicked by an opponent and then 25,000 people boo you for it.
It's all part of the fun and the flavour of the Barclays Premier League. And there's the biggest star in it at the moment, Wayne Rooney. What a talent. He takes a fair old battering every game he plays. got his own back there, though he had been fouled just before that. Vinic. Well, the Bolton fans are playing their part, really trying to rally their team. He hits it long. Never does well to block the path of Davis.
The ball was just slightly overhead, wasn't it? But you can see the intentions of Bolton this second half. They didn't do it enough in the first half. Just trying to keep loading balls onto the head of Evra, because Kevin Davis undoubtedly will get a lot of success with his heading ability.
There is the head of Davis, putting it towards the corner flag. The youth chasing Vinic, who does enough. Signed in the winter last year for £7 million. Came in from Spartak Moscow. And he settled in the Manchester United way of life, and we've got a ball boy down there in the shape of El Hamsti. Van der Sar was taking his time, so a Senegal international assisted him by putting it on the six-yard line. Meets his header. Ivan Campo. To the right boot of Jaskalainen, who clears the ball despite doing the splits. Nice touch from Vinic. He looks outstanding today. Line. There's a little nudge on Davis, ignored by the referee. I think he may have made a mistake there. Campo.
I think it was possibly another one that Rob Stiles didn't see. So how could he give it, Rob?
That was clearly the case. He didn't see that either, as Rooney appeared to be the victim of a tangle of legs. Of pushing and shoving. They've come from far and wide to play in this match, but it does have the passion of the local derby that it is. Ryan Giggs dives in. Well, it's rare that Bolton get such a crowd. They do struggle to get supporters into this excellent stadium. They have today. They want to put on a show for the locals. They need a goal. Vinic, as if it's on the trampoline, the way that he springs over the Bolton players. Hunt. Manchester United are going to make a change in a moment. They're programming the change of numbers in the board. Heinze is going to come on. Would expect it to be Evra that goes off, but he's got some defensive work to do in the meantime. There is Evra. There's Giggs. Rooney. Knew what he was going to do well before the ball arrived at his feet. And Elka chases. Juf. Forced back and goes from an offensive position to a defensive position. Had to give it to his goalkeeper. And that was due to the closing down of Manchester United. Took a heavy blow a few moments ago. Davis was booked for the foul on him, and Evra's going to have to come off, and Haynes is going to come on. He doesn't want to go off. And they call for the stretcher. His chariot's arrived. most players. Trevor likes to hobble off, don't they? Not too many like to go off on this stretcher, but he must be feeling the pain.
Yes, I just hope it's nothing serious, because it was a nasty challenge from Kevin Davis. Certainly Bolton have been better, haven't they, in this second half? They've got in the faces of Manchester United. They've not allowed them to dictate like they were in the first half. Been more physical with them. And it's more like the Bolton that we've come to expect over the years. That's what would have disappointed Sam in the first half, Sam Allardyce. They didn't play as he wants them to play. I thought they were very, very tentative. Sat off Manchester United, and that could be fatal against a team of such outstanding individual players, what Manchester United have got on this field.
Well, the Argentinian international comes on for the French recruit. So has good memories of Bolton Wanderers. His only league goal was scored against them.
This is what's known in the game as a sandwich. Stelios actually wins the ball, but Anelka and Stelios make the sandwich on Michael Carrick.
Short to Ronaldo. Carrick. Scholes. I think the word from the Manchester management is to try and keep possession. When they get the free kicks, they're not hoisting them into the opposing area. Trying to play total football, Manchester United. Play to their strengths, which is the quick feet of Rooney and Ronaldo and Giggs and Sahar. Zaha. Now Giggs. Manchester United moving through the gears. Ooh, Giggs couldn't quite get it there. Speed to Campo. Diouf. Campo continues the run. Those splayed feet catching Vidic. Even Campo has his own way of protesting. It's entertaining at times.
And Campo closes down Vidic, who has a touch. And then, for me, there's absolutely no contact at all. Vidic goes to ground, and the assistant referee is no more than 2 foot away. He raises his flag in favour of the Manchester United player. Campo, he can't quite believe it. And I can understand why, because there was absolutely no contact.
Ronaldo beaten by Ben Haim. No signs of movement yet on the Bolton bench. Ferdinand. Oh, he's giving it away to Diouf. Stelios supports. Chief, everywhere he looks, he sees a red shirt. There's a pull of the shirt there from Scholes.
Little tug of the shirt from Paul Scholes. Unnecessary. Gives Bolton the chance to load another ball into the Manchester United penalty box. They're now playing to their strengths, Bolton. Stop, start, the game's become very fragmented, and that suits Bolton.
Oh, the goalkeeper, Van der Sar, had to backpedal there. Under some heavy pressure from Davis. Bolton are going to have to use some bullying techniques, of course, within the confines of the laws of the game. Here's speed. It's better from Bolton. Nicola Anelka. Draws two. Can he get the cross in? Takes his time. Flips it in there. Good confident call from Vidic again. Speed. And Vidic leads this one to Van der Sar. Away he goes, Rooney. He's got his mind set on a hat-trick. Great tackle by Ben Hayim. Samuel Dice can't contain himself, he's down there.
What he was trying to do was get Bona to take the throw in quickly because he realises that they've upped the tempo and it suits their style much, much better.
And Paul Scholes has snapped and a couple of defences in the space of a couple of minutes. He's got a yellow card.
Well, Paul Scholes can't complain, can he? Because he got away with a little shirt pull on El Hadj just a couple of minutes ago. This was another rash challenge came in on Ben Haim.
Sam Allardyce's 200th Premiership game. And Sam Elia down there, barking instructions. Davis flicks it into the six-yard box, away by Ferdinand. It's got to be up and at him from the home side. Campo. That's not a bad cross at all. Finds her way. Giggs stopped by Speed. Meter. Davis flicks on. Anelka comes in from the wing and Gary Nabel takes the sensible approach. Manchester United are having to dig deep in the second half. Three quarters of the game gone. They have a two-goal advantage. Campo's long throw. Oh, the goalkeeper bullied off the ball. Van der Sar was just knocked off balance. His focus was on a ball in the sky.
Take your pick here, Stelios or El Hadj Diouf.
Well, the change is made. Nicky Hunt, the right fullback, is coming off. The number nine, Pedersen, who was a centre forward when he was given that number, is coming on. He has played at left back this season, and that looks as though it's going to be the position that he's going to occupy for the next 22, 23 minutes of this game. Ben Haim has gone to right back, taking a step to the right in a Sam Allardyce reshuffle. Carrick. Zaha. Here is Pedersen. Ferdinand lets it go across his body and just absorbs it back to Van der Sar. Rooney's touch, lovely touch. Giggs. Takes his time, will select the right pass. Ooh, it was Zaha. It was just a fraction underneath the ball.
Should have done better, Rob. It was a glorious ball from Ryan Giggs. He had the option of Heinze, who made the overlap on the left-hand side. That gave him an extra split second to look up. He picks out Zaha with a free header. And he should have done much, much better with that.
Heinze. This is Pedersen. Now Giggs. Rooney. Was fouled down in a crumpled heap. He was winded the way he landed. Mita leaves his mark, escapes a booking. Zaha. There's Anelka. Speed. Stelios. Pedersen. We said at the start of the day that Bolton had the best defence. They'd only conceded four goals. Manchester United actually have a better defence than them now. They've conceded only 5 this season, now scored 21. So United have the best defence and the best attack. And they'll be top of the table if it stays this way.
And the midfield's not bad either.
Nicola Anelka was given a lot of plaudits by Sir Alex before the game. Samuel I snipped in to buy him at the end of the summer. Sir Alex said that he's considered moving in for Anelka over the last few years, but the time has never quite been right. Scholes to Giggs. Ooh, you could see what he wanted to do, but for once the viewfinder of Ryan Giggs was
what a chance that was for Manchester United. Careless pass from Ryan Giggs. Ronaldo was in yards of space.
Davis. Diouf. Davis with it. Diouf drops the shoulder, gets past Vinic. It was his own momentum that took him over in the view of Rob Stiles, who had a good view of him.
I don't think anyone in the ground really felt that was a penalty, not even the most biased of Bolton supporters.
And maybe his excuse will be that he found a divot, but wouldn't mess with a Bolton groundsman. He's a pretty fierce character. Stelios. Faye has left his central defensive post to lead the charge. Stelios is offside. Well, certainly in the second half, it's been an more ordered Bolton Wanderers. They just got off to a very sloppy, sluggish, slow start. Something that I'm sure would have been pointed out by Sam Allardyce at half-time. Zaha. Rooney. Zaha. Great roof! Oh, Jasker Leinen! Well, they liken him to Peter Schmeichel. And even the Manchester United fans give the Bolton goalkeeper a standing ovation there. That was a tremendous save.
Great save and a classic 1-2. Zaha to Rooney, plays it back to Zaha, who composed himself one-on-one in a brilliant save from Jasker Leinen.
Now Manchester United step on the gas. Ronaldo. Carrick, Rooney takes a deflection, handball. You can hear the cry from here of Wayne Rooney. I bet he would want to take the penalty if they got one as well on a hat-trick.
This is the 1-2. Zaha played back to him by Rooney. Escapes his marker with a lunging challenge. Zaha goes clear. One-on-one. And how many times have we seen that where the goalkeeper comes out on top of the forward? Jasker Leinen, one of the best in the business. He's been an outstanding player for Sam Allardyce at Bolton.
The final 15 minutes. This is normally where Manchester United come into their own. Stelios. Ferdinand.
You have to say, Rob, that save from Jasker Leinen has really kept the contest alive, because 3-0, the game was all over.
A string of fine saves from Jasker Leinen. Stelios, that's his foot underneath it. Davis heads it down, Campbell! Well, it wasn't the prettiest of saves by Van der Sar. Doesn't matter as long as you keep them out.
Well, Campbell's already got 3 goals to his name this season, and he's very close to his 4th. Davis outjumps Neville, nods it back into the box. Campbell swivels it with his left foot, and a good save.
Oh, it's still not over, and it was charged down by Sahar. The referee signals that he saw it, and it wasn't handball, despite the mass clutching of straws at the Reebok. Cristiano Ronaldo. Apparently he did lose his feet, and there's some heavy pressure from Gary Speed, and they asked why the penalty wasn't given a moment ago. The reason being, it didn't really hit his arm, did it?
I think it did hit his arm, but Sahar was no more than 3 yards away from Faye. He smashes it at him, he couldn't get out the way of it. It's not intentional for me.
Now Giggs. What a tremendous attitude of El Hatch de Youth today. He's gone chasing for the ball. Oh dear, now Rooney's got a chance. Rooney tried to pass it in. That worked for his second goal, but probably for me to criticise Wayne Rooney, it wasn't what was needed on that occasion.
Great challenge from Rio Ferdinand, dispossesses Anelka. The ball runs loose to Wayne Rooney. He picked the wrong option, didn't he? Tried to chip Yaskalainen when really he should have driven the ball towards goal.
Ivan Campbell. Ben Hayim, they line up anticipating the cross. And Gary Neville was at the head of the line, and he's taken a nasty blow to his head in saving the situation for United.
Once again, Campbell in the opposing penalty box. He's gone looking to try and get himself a goal. I think he was looking to try and get on the end of this ball from Ben Hayim. It was a great header from Neville. In fact, it was his own player. I think it was Michael Carrick that caught him with his boot. Campbell says, I'm not involved. Well, once again, Campbell penalised when there was absolutely no contact from the player. Quite clearly, that was Carrick's right boot that was raised.
When you look against you, it is against you, isn't it? Credit Bolton, they haven't given up the fight, haven't given up the hope. Keep pressing Manchester United. Sir Alex's side have been stretched at times. That's a poor touch by Ben Hayim. That's a wonderful touch from Rooney. Ronaldo to Saha. Neville to Scholes. Heinze on the left. Now Paul Scholes. Heinze trying to play the ball in to the goal, Manchester United. And Bolton counter-attack. They're taking a gamble. They've left effectively three up front. Diouf right across Ferdinand, and it's the officials, or the assistant official on the far side, who gives the free kick.
Real Ferdinand gets too tight on El Hadj Diouf. A little nudge in the back, and El Hadj Diouf is not going to turn that down. Goes to floor immediately, but he was entitled to, because Real Ferdinand got far too tight to him.
Cluster of white shirts around the penalty spot, hit in with hope, and that was a great catch by Van der Sar. Came through a congested area to claim that. Darren Fletcher and John O'Shea are preparing to come on for Manchester United, and a double change. Manchester United are in a good position in the Champions League, but Sir Alex will want to keep his players at the peak of their form for the game against FC Copenhagen in midweek. Campo, Stelios, Speed to Diouf, beats one. Puts in the cross, Ulfinic gives it away, Stelios' shot, and it's blocked by Ferdinand, who ran right across the path of Davies to prevent him challenging the goalkeeper.
Well, there was no need for the referee to even consider giving a decision because the assistant referee had actually flagged for offside against Kevin Davis, which was acknowledged by Rob Stiles.
Well, there's a slip. Now Sahar. Ronaldo's alongside it. There he is. And that's three, and that's the points in the bag. And that is Manchester United, undisputedly, still at the top of the table.
Well, I've spoken all game about the movement of Sahar. Here you see a demonstration, A, of the player's control of the ball, great control on his chest, and then just look at the vision of Sahar, one-on-one with the keeper, but he just waits for the support to come. It arrives with Ronaldo. Sahar rows the ball across the box and says to Ronaldo, go on, son, put that into the empty net. And he does that with ease.
Open goal. Cristiano Ronaldo caps a magnificent Manchester United performance. Now it's time to give a couple of players a break. John O'Shea comes on. And Sahar, who got the assist for that goal, goes off. For Bolton Wanderers, Stelios has run himself into the ground and Edan Tal comes on. And Darren Fletcher's coming on and Ryan Giggs will be taken off once they can capture his attention, he knows now.
Substitutions for Manchester United, replacing number 9, Lewis Sahar, and number 11, Ryan Giggs, and number 22, John O'Shea, and number 24, Darren Fletcher. And
the substitutes Sir Alex, I'm sure, making sure that everybody gets a stretch of the legs. Game is won now. Just protect a couple of players. Keep things nice and active for the Champions League in midweek. The Manchester United fans in tremendous voice now.
Well, John O'Shea just picked up a yellow card for kicking the ball away. That must be one of the quickest yellow cards ever recorded for a player coming on as a sub, because he hadn't kicked the ball, had he, apart from the one he just kicked away there.
We'll check it later. It must have been about 15 seconds. Campo teases it up. Carrick is there. Deeve helps it on. Away's the call. And wasn't quite away, but it did show the confidence of Vidic in his goalkeeper.
He wasn't sure, was he, Vidic? He wanted to just help it on its way back to Van der Sar, but he wasn't exactly sure where Van der Sar was positioned. He heard the call, but he wasn't sure where he was.
He's at the Reebok. And his team are leading 3-0. And it's an opportunity to give one of the Bolton stars of the future the taste of the big time. Johan Smith, 19 years of age, his only appearance was against Charlton in midweek, comes on for Kevin Davis, who again has run himself into the ground but without any reward this afternoon. We can confirm, Trevor, I know you wanted to know it, that John O'Shea was on for 57 seconds before he was booked.
I didn't think it was as long as that, Rob. I wouldn't have mentioned it if I had thought that.
Ladies, avert your eyes. Elhan Steve's having some treatment to his rear. Vidic's header. Was impeded as he went for the ball. Referee did well. They just held his whistle to see what developed before giving the free kick. Vidic. Van der Sar. Fletcher. Carrick. Robert. We want four, is the cry from the United fans.
Well, if they're going to get four, they're going to have to do it with just one forward up, and that's Wayne Rooney, because Manchester United now are playing with a five-man midfield, and Rooney is being left as the sole striker.
Well, the signs are that Manchester United are back to their menacing best, and Chelsea have some opposition for the Premier League title this season. The referee has a little situation to sort out over there. Ben Haim slid into Ronaldo, who offers him forgiveness. He was late, and I'll tell you what, he's not escaped the yellow card, I don't think.
It's a late challenge. Ronaldo was actually off the field, wasn't he?
Hence the throw and not the free kick. Poor old Ben Haim. He's had a great season, but today he and his fellow defenders have been run ragged by Manchester United. It's getting scrappy. Wright has helped to his feet now. Succession of free kicks given away. We've got 3 minutes or so remaining. And given how tight it is at the top, Sir Alex will have set his defence the target of not conceding. There'll be no laying off, Bolton. He'll want the four, he'll want the five if he can get it. They'll be top on goals difference, Manchester United.
I can tell you one thing, Rob, there won't be another team this season who would come to the Reebok and win as convincingly as this, 3-0. It really is a very, very good performance from Manchester United, especially in the first half. For the opening 20 minutes in the second half, Bolton were good, but they really needed to score in that period. Manchester United saw it through and have come back strong to wrap the game up through Cristiano Ronaldo.
Nita. Rooney's through. Rooney's on a hat-trick. Rooney gets his hat-trick! Happy belated 21st, Wayne Rooney.
Well, that's as good as hat-trick as you're going to see. Every goal is an absolutely beautiful clinical finish. He's a great striker of the ball, Wayne Rooney. Darren Fletcher played his part, but it's an awful pass, this from Mita. Gives it away to Fletcher, who plays in Rooney, who composes himself, and then strikes the ball nice and cleanly with his right foot. Once again, Jaskalainen, who has been outstanding this afternoon, has absolutely no chance. Three goals to Wayne Rooney, and three goals that have been absolutely brilliant finishes.
What do you give the man who's got everything? What can't money buy for your 21st birthday? A match ball for your first Premiership hat-trick. Colleen didn't think of that, did she? Can't get one from Harrods. Sam Allardyce's team in the opening nine games of the season have conceded only four goals against Sir Alex in 90 minutes. They've conceded four. You can't hide the smile either, can he, Sir Alex?
Well, and also, Rob, you can't hide the fact that Bolton defensively have been very weak this afternoon. I mentioned earlier in the game the two centre-halves have been very uncomfortable, Mita and Faye. And it was Mita who made that horrible pass, trying to pick out a colleague in the centre of midfield, gave it straight to Darren Fletcher, who released Wayne Rooney, who scored with aplomb.
Bad news for Bolton, there's another 3 minutes to endure. Rooney's never scored four. That's his target now. Ferdinand hits it long. There is Rooney.
There's a line there I could have mentioned with myself, but I won't mention it. Yes, I will. I scored four against Bolton.
On your 21st?
Well, I was 16, Rob.
Were you? Well, I hope in 20 years' time that I'm standing alongside Wayne Rooney commentating. And he's your age. And Changed youth. Tao. Mita. Ben Haim's cross and Ferdinand in the way. It's been a tremendous team effort. Rooney here will get the headlines for his goal-scoring exploits. Doesn't score for months and then they come in threes. But every single Manchester United player has been at the peak of their form today. Pedersen. Speed. Overcooked. Gary Speed was a hero, of course, of Wayne Rooney's when he was playing for Rooney's beloved Everton. Campo. Now Carrick. Fletcher. It's a great ball. Gary Neville still going strong. And he was caught by here. Number 42, Johan Smith. A name like Johan, he should be wearing 14, shouldn't he? Ronaldo, oh, through the legs of Smith. The teenager taught a lesson there. Full-time whistle goes, and that confirms Wayne Rooney scored the first Premiership hat-trick of the season of any player. He marks a significant week in his life by scoring a hat-trick of goals. Sir Alex's side were, well, absolutely magnificent. Outperforming and outgunning Bolton Wanderers by 4-0. And going back to the top of the table. Sir Alex, congratulations. Sum up an excellent afternoon for me.
It was a fantastic result for us. In the first half in particular, we played fantastic football. In the first 25 minutes, we could have been 4 up, really. Very unlucky with some of the opportunities we had, but it was great football and I really enjoyed it.
Was the idea to come out flying as you did today?
Well, I think to try and play a normal game. It's, you know, we've got great pace and ability up front and we get good service into those players, Rooney and Saha and Ronaldo and Giggs, and I think they've excelled today.
Which everybody wonders what you should buy Wayne Rooney for a 21st birthday. A hat-trick isn't a bad thing. He's first in the Premiership.
Well, he was due to score at some point. There's no doubt about that. And I'm just pleased he got off the mark because, you know, the longer these things go on for strikers, they start to doubt things, you know. But they're all the same strikers. When they score, the confidence goes up. And you saw as soon as they scored, there was more to come.
So that's 4 straight wins for Manchester United. And they are back to the top of the Premiership after arguably their best performance of the season. After the break, it's time to go interactive. 8 games played in the Barclays Premiership today and they're all available to you in Match Choice. Here's just a little taste of what you can expect.